Hello children, welcome back to 9th standard science class. In the last class we were discussing about the differences between speed and velocity, and we have solved some problems, I hope. Today let us discuss about one more problem. I told if possible you work out, otherwise I will work out, I said. Let us see how to solve this problem. See, look at page number, I have written the problem here on the board. One problem I have written, next onwards I tell you the page number, you have to refer it and write it in your classwork. Here is a problem, and in the last class we have also discussed about the instrument used to measure the distance travelled. What is the instrument that is in the vehicle? Distance travelled is measured using an instrument called odometer. So odometer of the vehicle is used to measure the distance travelled. Now let us work out another problem here. During an experiment, a signal from a spaceship reached the ground station in 5 minutes. What was the distance of the spaceship from the ground station? You have to find the distance. You know the formula to find the speed. Speed V is equal to what? Distance travelled divided by time taken. Distance travelled is S and time taken is T. So what is the formula to be used? What is given here? The time taken is given and speed of the signal travels in the at the speed of light. You know the speed of light. It is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. In the same speed the signal travels. So what is given? Time taken is given, 5 minutes, and the speed of the signal is given. Speed is given and it is equal to the speed of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8. What is given? Let us write first. Solution. How to solve the problem? Try to understand the problem. During an experiment, a signal from a spaceship reached the ground station in 5 minutes. So time taken is 5 minutes. You have to find the distance of the spaceship from the ground station. To find the distance, you need the speed here. The speed is given, which is equal to the speed of light. That is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So write speed V is given here, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and time T is given. Time T is given, that is 5 minutes. So you have to convert this minutes into seconds. How to convert? 5 minutes equal to 5 into 60 seconds. 5 into 60, that is 300 seconds. So how many seconds? 5 minutes means 300 seconds. Now you know the speed. To find speed, the formula is speed V is equal to distance traveled, S by time taken T. We have already learnt in the previous class, speed V is equal to S is distance and T is time taken. Here, what is given here? V is given, speed is given, 3 into 10 to the power 8, and time is given. You have to find distance, yes. Now, substitute distance, yes, is equal to what it is? Speed into time, V into T. So, what is the formula? You have to modify the formula here. Speed is given, time is given, you have to find the distance. So distance S is equal to distance S is equal to V into T. Look at here, V into T. So now V is given. What is V? It is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second into time T is. T is 300 seconds. Now simplify, 3 3s are 9 900 into 10 to the power 8, and you can convert 900 into powers, 9 into 10 to the power 2. So 900 is nothing but 9 into 10 to the power 2. So how can you write this? You can simplify. This is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 8 plus 2. Means what? 9 into 10 to the power 10 meter. So distance is measured in meters. So it is nothing but 9 into 10 to the power 10 meters is the answer for this question. So did you understand how to solve? Distance S is equal to speed V into time T. Speed is 3 into 10 to the power 8 into time is 300 seconds. That is nothing but 900 into 10 to the power 8. So let us convert this 900 in terms of power. If you write, it is 9 into 10 to the power 2. So that is 9 into 10 to the power 8 plus 2, that is 10. What is the answer now? The distance of the spaceship from the ground station is 9 into 10 to the power 10 meters. I hope you have understood the problem. Now let us work out one more problem from the textbook. Refer the textbook. I don't write the problem, and copy this problem in your classwork. Must copy the problem and then solve the problem. Now let us move on to another problem. Look at the textbook, page number 102. Here is a worked out example. Let us work out how to solve the problem. The odometer of a car reads 2000 km at the start of a trip and 2400 km at the end of the trip. If the trip took 8 hours, calculate the average speed of the car in kilometer per hour and meter per second. So what is given? Start of the trip, what is the distance covered? It shows 2000 km and at the end of the trip 2400 km. Now what is the distance covered by the car? Distance covered by the car is 2400 minus 2000, and time taken is how many hours? 8 hours time is taken. What is the average speed of the car? You have to write it in kilometer per hour also and convert it into meter per second also. So how to solve the problem? Copy the problem and then let us write the solution now. So page number, I'll write the problem number, page 102, 8.2, example 8.2. Now I already read the problem. Now let us write the solution. What is given? The solution. Let us write the solution. What is given? Distance covered by a car is given. Distance covered by a car. That is equal to, at the start of the trip, the odometer. You know, odometer is used to measure the distance traveled. So odometer shows the reading 2000 km at the start of the trip and 2400 km at the end of the trip. Then what is the distance covered? You have to subtract 2400 minus 2000. So that is equal to 2400 km minus 2000 km. So what is the distance traveled? That is equal to 400 km. So what is the distance traveled? 400 km. And what is the time taken? Time taken, T is equal to, it is given 8 hours. Time taken is 8 hours. Now, what is the average speed? Average speed is equal to average speed V is equal to S by T. Write the formula. S is nothing but distance traveled divided by T is time taken. So, distance traveled is how many kilometers? 400 kilometers and time taken is 8 hours. Now, what is the average speed of the vehicle? 8 ones are 8, 50s are 8, 5s are 40s. So, 50 kilometer per hour. So, what is the speed, average speed of the cars? It is 50 kilometer per hour. How to convert this into meter per second? 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters and 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes and 60 minutes equal to 60 seconds. You have to convert the time into seconds. So, how to change? You have already learned this. The speed in kilometers is 50 kilometer per hour. In meter per second, it is how to convert 50 kilometer into 1000 divided by time taken is 3600. How it is? 60 minutes into 60 seconds. 60 minutes means 1 hour equal to 60 minutes. So convert this into seconds. 60 into 60, 366 are 36. So 3600 seconds. So 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. So how to convert 50 kilometer per hour into meter per second? 50 kilometer into 1000, because 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter divided by 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. Now simplify. Two fives are 2, 2 nines are. So 25 fives are 125 divided by 9. So how much it is? 9 ones are 9, 3 remains 32, 9 threes are 27, you will get 13.88 meter per second, or you can write 13.9 meter per second. So 50 kilometer per hour is 13.9 meter per second. So this is how we can solve the problem. Another problem is there, worked out problem. Usha swims in a 90 meter long pool. She covers 180 meters in 1 minute by swimming from one end to the other and back along the same straight path. Find the average speed and the average velocity of Usha. Average speed, here total distance covered by Usha in 1 minute is 90 meter long. She covers 180 meter in 1 minute by swimming from one end to the other and back along the same path. So what is the distance covered by her? It is 180 meter in 1 minute. So displacement of Usha in 1 minute is 0. We have discussed in the last class, when an object starts from initial position, reaches the final position, and if it comes back to initial position again, when the initial and the final position of the object is the same, then what is the displacement? Displacement is 0. So what is the displacement of Usha here? She swims in a 90 meter long pool, covers 180 meters, starts one end to the other and comes back along the same path, and then you can infer here initial position and final position of Usha is the same. So what is her displacement in 1 minute? Displacement in 1 minute is 0. Now what is the average speed of the distance traveled is 180 meter in 1 minute and distance displacement is zero. Average speed is nothing but distance, total distance covered divided by total time taken. Total distance covered is 180 meter, but here 1 minute is given. You have to convert it into second. So it is nothing but 60 seconds. So 180 divided by 60, that is 3 meter per second. So what is her speed? It is average speed of Usha is 3 meter per second. What is average velocity? Velocity is equal to, what is it? Velocity is equal to displacement by time taken. Displacement we have already written there. Displacement is 0. So what is her velocity? Displacement V, velocity V is equal to displacement 0 divided by time taken 60 seconds. So it is 0 by 60, 0. What is her velocity? It is 0 meter per second. Her average speed is 3 meter per second. So this is how we have to solve the problem. Write this problem also in your notebook. Two problems also must be written in the notebook. Let us move on to another measure that you have learnt in 8th standard. Let us recall, what is acceleration? Rate of change of velocity. Let us move on to another topic. Rate of change of velocity. Rate of change of velocity. When an object is traveling in uniform motion, its velocity changes. The velocity remains constant. Does its velocity change? If an object is in uniform motion. If an object is in uniform motion, its velocity remains constant. So, what is the change in velocity? The change in velocity of the object at any time interval is zero. So, when an object is in uniform motion, its velocity remains constant and the change of velocity at any time interval will be zero. Suppose if an object is traveling in non-uniform motion, its velocity of the object, it changes. Yes or no? The change in velocity of an object in non-uniform motion is not zero. Means it changes with respect to time. So can you define the term now? What is acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but the rate of change of velocity or the change in velocity per unit time is called acceleration. So what is acceleration? It is defined as the rate of change of velocity. What is it called? Acceleration. Or it is the measure of, acceleration is the measure of, is the measure of the change in velocity, change in the velocity of the object, velocity of the object per unit time, per unit time. So what is acceleration? It is nothing but the measure of the change in the velocity of the object per unit time. So now, can you write an expression for acceleration? Acceleration A is equal to, so acceleration is denoted by, acceleration A is equal to change in velocity. Look at the definition. It is the change in the velocity of the object per unit time. Change in the velocity. Change in velocity divided by time taken. Change in velocity divided by time taken. Now, what can you write it in the form of expression? What is change in velocity? Velocity of an object changes from initial velocity u to final velocity v. So, velocity of an object changes from initial velocity u to final velocity v. Can you tell me now what is the change in velocity? Change in velocity is equal to v minus u divided by time is t. So, it is the expression for acceleration. V minus u is the change in velocity. I hope you have understood. Velocity of an object, if it changes from initial velocity u to final velocity v, then the change in velocity is nothing but v minus u by t. What is the SI unit of acceleration? SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. So, meter per second square is the unit of acceleration. Now, acceleration of an object may be positive when the acceleration becomes positive. If the acceleration is in the direction of velocity, then it is positive. And if the acceleration is in the opposite direction of velocity, it is negative. So, the acceleration is taken to be positive when acceleration is taken to be positive when it is in the direction of velocity. And it is taken to be negative. When it is in the opposite direction of velocity. Acceleration of an object is taken to be positive when it is in the direction of its velocity. And it is taken to be negative. Acceleration is taken to be negative when it is in the opposite direction of its velocity. So, this is about acceleration. What is the expression for acceleration? It is v minus u by t. Means v minus u is the change in velocity divided by time t. And what is the SI unit of acceleration? It is nothing but meter per second square. And it is taken to be positive. Acceleration is taken to be positive when it is in the direction of velocity. And it is taken to be negative when it is in the opposite direction of its velocity. Now what is uniform acceleration and non-uniform acceleration? Uniform acceleration means what? When an object is traveling in a straight line and its velocity increases or decreases by equal amounts in equal intervals of time, it is said to be in uniform acceleration. So, what is meant by uniform acceleration? If an object is traveling in a straight line, its velocity increases or decreases by equal amounts in equal intervals of time, it is said to be in uniform acceleration. What is meant by non-uniform acceleration? The object may be traveling in non-uniform acceleration, when its velocity changes by unequal amounts in equal intervals of time, or when it travels in non-uniform acceleration. In the sense, what it is, when an object is in non-uniform acceleration, when it is in non-uniform acceleration, when its velocity changes by unequal amounts in equal intervals of time, it is said to be in non-uniform acceleration. So, can you give an example for uniform acceleration? So, if an object is moving, freely falling object. Example is, the motion of a freely falling object is an example of uniformly accelerated motion. So, what is the example of uniformly accelerated motion? It is nothing but motion of a freely falling object is an example of uniform acceleration. So, or uniformly accelerated motion. And what is the example of non-uniform acceleration or non-uniform accelerated motion? I mean, what is the example? If a car is traveling on a straight road and its velocity changes by unequal amounts at equal intervals of time, it is said to be in non-uniform acceleration. So, I hope you have understood what is uniform acceleration. Now, if an object travels in a straight line and the velocity increases or decreases by equal amounts at equal intervals of time, it is said to be in accelerated motion. So, what is uniform acceleration? Very important, uniform acceleration is an object is traveling in a straight line. If an object is traveling in a straight line, the velocity increases or decreases by its velocity increases or decreases by equal amounts in equal intervals of time. It is said to be in uniform acceleration. Can you define what is uniform acceleration? If an object is traveling in a straight line, its velocity increases or decreases by equal amounts in equal intervals of time, it is said to be in uniform acceleration. What is non-uniform acceleration? If an object is traveling in a straight line, if its velocity increases or decreases by unequal amounts at equal intervals of time, then it is said to be in non-uniform acceleration. Can you give an example for uniform acceleration? Motion of a freely falling body is an example of accelerated motion. Uniformly accelerated motion. Non-uniform acceleration means, example already I have given, If a car travels in a straight line, if its velocity increases or decreases or changes by unequal amounts at equal intervals of time, it is said to be in non-uniform acceleration. Let us learn some problems in the next class. See you then.